Do you want to learn how to quickly and easily build flexible web applications and dashboards? If you're new to this channel and you're keen to learn the latest tips, tricks, and tools for working more effectively with data, please hit the subscribe button for weekly videos. This video is inspired by a couple of students on my new course, Our Shiny Flex Dashboards and Interactive Data Visualizations. So thank you very much to Riccardo and Julian for posting your excellent questions. It is so great to see you doing some really, really cool stuff with these applications. So Julian is based out in Australia and he's using some of this to present some of his research. And Riccardo is building some pretty cool applications to calculate Bitcoin mining profits. So very, very interesting stuff. Really, really great to see. Now, a few of these questions are to do with how to filter and present tabular data through the dashboard and make it a little bit more interactive and a little bit more dynamic. So here I have set up a sort of Flex dashboard template. Now, really, in order to do this, all you need to do is come over to the new button, R Markdown, from template and pick this template. But basically what I've done here is I've used an existing template and I've just deleted out a bunch of stuff just to make it easier to see on my screen here. So what we're going to do is I'm going to import the library tidyverse. And over here, this is where my main chart or table is going to be. So I'm just going to type in here render data table, and I'm just going to start with the Star Wars data set, just so you can see what this looks like. Right, so what you can see here is a table of data in a JavaScript object. Now the cool thing is that you didn't have to write any JavaScript to be able to enable this. And this has got all of the data in the background of this web application. So when you want to filter it, you can just type in this search box here. So let's say I wanted to find all the people with blonde hair. I can start typing in blonde and it effectively searches across all of the columns, which is a really cool and really great feature. Now, one of the things with this is if you have a very, very large data set, you may not want to have all the data sent down to the client straight away. What you may want to do is filter it on the server side so that the results basically load up faster and you're not sending too much data. Okay, so what we're going to do here is we're going to do a few things. We're going to start to add some drop-down menus and filter options, which we can use to restrict the data that comes back in the first place. So let's go ahead and do that. Let me close that down for a while. So if I want to add an input box here, I can do something like I can do a select input. I'm going to give it an ID. So the ID is, let's say, filter column. So this is basically to select the column that we want to filter on. So filter column. And I'm going to set the choices for this equal to basically names of the Star Wars. Now, basically what the names function does, it returns all the columns for Star Wars. So that will give me a drop-down menu. Let me add another line in here. And the next thing I want to do is add a, say, text box. So let me say text input. And this is going to be my filter value. So filter value. And over here, all I'm going to do is add a filter command. And effectively what I want to do is I want to say input filter column is equal to input filter value. Yep. Let me spell that right. Okay. Now, that's the essence of what we want to do here. Now, the only problem with this, and the reason why this won't work, is because this over here is a text. And this over here is also a text. So this is effectively going to say the name column is equal to Luke Skywalker or something like that. And that's not going to work because those aren't equivalent to each other. What you want to actually do is say the filter column or the filter, so the column object, you know, the column object, which is name, is equal to whatever name that you type in. Now, in order to do that, we're going to use a method from tidy evaluation. And I go over tidy evaluation in a lot more detail in my course, but it's actually quite a big subject in itself. So here I'm just going to implement it. So I'm going to use two exclamation marks, and I'm going to use this function rlang_sim. And effectively, that's what that's going to do for us. It is going to take this text input and convert it into a column for us to be able to do this filter check. So let's run that. Okay, so now here we have, again, all the names of the columns down here like this. So if I take name and say type in something like Darth Vader, right, we can see we get that record back, and it's restricted the amount of data that has come back to the client. So a very, very useful technique, especially when you're working with much larger data sets. Now, another thing that would be quite cool, I think, to do is go, okay, maybe make this a drop-down menu as well, so that you get a list of all the names. And that's not too hard to do, but probably not something that we can cover in the space of this video. So if you want to be able to build cool little dashboards like this, you can get a free sample of my course at www.datastrategywithjonathan.com. Also, to let you know, I am working on a new data analytics masterclass where I'm planning to build out tons more cool content. So I was also going to show how to build a dynamic column selector, which was based on another question I had from Riccardo. But instead of trying to mash all of that together, I think that's probably best saved for another video. So look out for that next time. If you found this video helpful, please give a thumbs up. It really helps out a lot to keep the channel going. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.